Warm greetings to all my dear students. Today we are going to start our new chapter, that is Poverty as a Challenge. In this chapter, we will understand the concept of poverty, how it is going to be measured, how we will differentiate between poor and non-poor, and what are the different factors responsible for poverty in our country, and what are the different situations in which we can say that a particular family is in condition of poverty. This chapter helps us to understand the multidimensional problem of poverty. It also discusses the incidence of poverty in our country and helps in understanding the concept of poverty line. It also discusses the causes of poverty and measures taken by the government to solve this problem. Whenever we are considering this term poverty, there are certain pictures that will come in our mind, and that will be of quite resemblance with the picture that is shown on the screen. So poverty is a condition where there is lack of food, lack of shelter, lack of clothes, etc. So what really it is? In our daily life, we come across many people whom we think are poor. They could be landless laborers in villages, or people living in overcrowded jhuggis in cities. They could be daily wages workers at construction sites or child workers in dhabas. They could also be beggars with children in tatters. We see poverty all around us. In fact, every fourth person in India is a poor. This means roughly 260 million or 26 crore people in India live in poverty. This also means that India has the largest single concentration of poor in the world. This illustrates the seriousness of the challenges. So that will give us idea why poverty is considered as a challenge for our country like India. To understand the concept of poverty and where we will find these poor, let us consider a situation of Ramsar through a story. In the picture, it is shown the family of Ramsar, a 30-year-old Ramsar works as a daily wages laborer in a wheat flour mill near Ranchi in Jharkhand. He manages to earn around 1500 a month. He has to send money home to his old parents who live in a village near Ramgarh. Ramsaran lives in one room rented house in a crowded basti in the outskirts of the city. His wife Sunita Devi, Santa Devi, works as a part-time maid in a few houses and manages to earn another rupees 800. His elder son works as a helper in a tea shop to supplement the family income and earns another rupees 300. His 10-year-old daughter takes care of the younger siblings. This is a story of a Ramsaran. Now let us understand the story of Lakha Singh. Lakha Singh belongs to a small village near Meerut in Uttar Pradesh. His family does not own any land, so they do odd jobs for the big farmers at times. They get paid rupees 50 for a hard day's work. The family of eight cannot always manage to acquire meals a day. The women of the family spent the day chopping fodder and collecting firewood in the fields. He had to start earning when he was 10 years old. His father, a TB patient, passed away 2 years ago due to lack of medication. His mother now suffers from the same disease and life is slowly ebbing away. So these are the two conditions of the people, Ram Charan and Lakha Singh. So what we have derived from the cases that we have discussed right now, Ram Charan and Lakha Singh, they show that poverty means hunger of and lack of shelter. Poverty also means lack of clean water and sanitation facilities. Poor people are in a situation in which they are ill-treated at almost every place. It also means lack of a regular job at a minimum decent level. So this is the poverty, where people don't have food to eat, don't have clothes to wear, don't have house to live in. And many of us are fortunate enough to avail all these facilities, but still we do not understand the real situations that is prevailing in our country. And almost, we can say almost 26 crore people are living under poverty line. So we should not waste our food. We should always appreciate and extend help to these type of people in our country. In our next class, we will discuss how poverty can be seen by our social scientist. Thank you and have a nice day.